Today is October 16th, and today's quote is entitled, "It's All Mercy." And this is a quote from Srila Prabhupada. As usual, the devotee in an adverse condition of life accepts such a condition to be the mercy of the Lord. When Prikshit Maharaj was cursed, he thought, this is an opportunity. Because now I have 7 days to die, that's pretty good. So that gives me 7 days to prepare. So now I can find someone who can help me and sit down and hear from them. So he kind of got excited and he saw, actually, this is really good. This is an opportunity. He didn't take it, why me? What have I done to deserve this? The world is not fair. He saw it as an opportunity and he took advantage of it. That's the way a devotee understands that I was telling devotees yesterday. Sometimes we don't know why something's happening. But I always feel when I go back to Krishna and I'm going to ask him, why did you allow this to happen to me? It was putting me in so much stress. It made my life so difficult. And Krishna will say, because if I didn't, you wouldn't be here now. That's the way we understand it. Said, if Krishna doesn't put me through these situations, or if I don't accept the consequences of my, if I don't understand the consequences of my actions clearly, that I've created this problem or Krishna has desired this situation, because I need this to go back to Godhead, then I'll misunderstand the lessons within those. Now, Krishna loves his devotees, loves everybody, but especially loves his devotees. He doesn't like to see his devotees suffer. So if a devotee is suffering, either the devotee is creating his own suffering by his wrong action and thinking, or Krishna sees that there's some attachment there and the devotee needs to undergo some suffering in relation to that attachment to detach, because otherwise, on his own, he's too weak to detach. So if I always cause misery in a particular situation for that devotee, the devotee will sooner or later get the point that whenever I do this or try to do this or think about this, I suffer, and that's Krishna's arrangement. That's Krishna's mercy on me. So we're always trying to see what's the lesson in the suffering. What is Krishna trying to tell me, rather than think, why me? I don't deserve it. We always want to see Krishna as a loving God, as a merciful God, who's putting us through various situations, which he does only out of love and affection, because they will help us. And even though we may be suffering, that suffering sometimes is exactly what we need to understand what we're doing wrong. Because when you suffer, obviously, you've done something wrong. You're getting a reaction. And therefore, now you have time to look at that and say, why is this happening? Now, sometimes the suffering is emotional, but nonetheless, it's suffering. It's not a natural state of consciousness to be suffering. So even if I'm suffering emotionally, I can think, why? Why am I suffering emotionally? What did I do wrong? What's going on here? There's so many ways to think about this. That's Krishna consciousness. Now, if you want to take it up a notch, upgrade your consciousness, then a devotee thinks, this is mercy because whatever misery I'm suffering, I'm actually such a fallen, sinful person that I deserve to suffer much more. And Krishna is so kind. He's relieving that suffering so that I can be peaceful enough to engage in Krishna consciousness. Now, what did Prabhupada think when his business fell apart? Actually, Prabhupada quotes in this story of Prikshit Maharaj, Prabhupada talks about himself, is the same situation. It was an opportunity. That's how we saw it. This is mercy. He didn't take it like, I don't deserve this. No, Krishna's doing something. Krishna's saying something. Guru Maharaj is saying something. It's time to renounce. The business is not going to work. I had the same situation in my life. I had a business, 2008 hit. We couldn't make any money. I couldn't make enough money with the business to support myself. And I wanted to get out of the business, but I wasn't brave enough or smart enough. And then I had no choice. We couldn't make enough money to live on, so I had to do something else. So it was very similar. Thank you, Krishna, for doing that. And when it was happening, I knew Krishna was doing that because I was making the breakaway from that business, but I needed a bigger punch. So was it difficult to break away? Yeah, for a while it was. For a while, we had financial trouble, but gradually, We worked through it. Krishna's mercy, he took care of us, he helped us. We're his devotees, he protects us. So we always want to know, yeah, we always want to think, yeah, something's good here. When I meet Krishna, he's going to tell me, yeah, I put you through that because you wouldn't be here if I didn't. So that's the mantra for this. You wouldn't be here if I didn't do that to you. Hare Krishna.